dig into details and explore all the options one by one. The link of the web page I'm using for my reference will be given in the description below. So our very first option was about Voyager. So I've taken a web page from NASA's website. So the primary mission of Voyager was the exploration of Jupiter and Saturn. Let me inform you, there are two missions under the Voyager interstellar mission, the Voyager 1 and Voyager 2. Voyager 1 was about the exploration of Jupiter and Saturn, and Voyager 2 went on to explore Uranus and Neptune. Moving forward to the New Horizons as our very second option. So I've taken the web page from Wikipedia. The primary purpose of New Horizons was to perform a flyby study of Pluto's system, and a secondary mission was to fly by and study one or more other Kuiper Belt objects, or KBOs. So the New Horizon was an interplanetary space probe, and the primary mission was to fly by and study the Pluto system. So now, before we move for the third and the fourth option, we need to get familiar with the term called gravitational waves. So this webpage is taken from the website of LIGO, N-I-G-O, which is working on gravitational waves. So according to LIGO, gravitational waves are ripples in space-time caused by some most violent and energetic processes in the universe. And processes can be like the colliding black holes, the colliding supernovas, and colliding neutron stars. And gravitational waves are cosmic ripples that travel at speed of light, carrying with them informations about the origins as well as clues to the nature of gravity itself. Let me tell you, gravitational waves are like characteristics for heavenly bodies. Now let's check out our third option, the LISA Pathfinder. The LISA Pathfinder was launched from Earth in the direction of Sun. The spacecraft's main goal was to hold still and to be as motionless as possible. And the LISA Pathfinder is to be parked at L1, which is chosen as a parking spot in space. And the Pathfinder, and at L1, Pathfinder can orbit and maintain a nearly constant distance to Earth. So LISA Pathfinder will allow the scientists to test technology that will be used to future missions that will carry gravitational waves detectors. The Pathfinder mission, in short, is to be motionless for detection of gravitational waves. Gravitational waves can also be understood by an example of a moving boat in a lake. When a boat sails in a lake, it generates ripple around its path. Such ripples in space-time fabric are called cosmic ripples or gravitational waves. So now let's check out our last option, ELISA. So I've taken this webpage, belongs to the Hindu newspaper. So according to this paragraph, ELISA is a plan of setting into space three aircrafts, a mother and two daughter aircrafts, which will fly in triangular formation, trailing the Earth in its orbit around the Sun at a distance of over 50 million kilometers. That is, the ELISA mission has three aircrafts, which is following Earth in its orbit around the Sun, that is the revolution of Earth. And the triangular formation is such that the arm of that imaginary triangle is about a million kilometers. Inside the spacecraft, there are falling test masses, which are cubes of sizes 46 millimeters. ELISA interferometers are detectors, which accurately measures changes in distance between these cubes due to the gravitational wave in space. So this is what our question was all about. Thank you.
This video will be always here. Come back to watch.